Good morning, my name is Martin.
My name is Dirkje.
And we are the tribe of the fox. So, today we would like to speak about ritual tools for people who were into hedonism, paganism, witchcraft, shamanism. So, you are used to see me here on this couch alone, but now Dirkje is here. She's visiting me today, so that's pretty awesome. And Dirkje has brought along her ritual equipment, her tools, and so have I.
Yeah.
So, Dirkje, what shall we start with?
Yeah, I think we start with the drum. I think everybody who is doing things with shamanism or witchcraft or paganism, most people want to have a drum. So I show you mine. This is the back. This is from beaver. And this is the front. This is cow. And I made this myself. It's nice if you make your own things, because when you make your own things, you put your own energy in it. And I've got a little bit help making this. But yeah, it is. I like this. I mean, it is. I can show you how it sounds. So it is not a big one, but the sound is very warm, and I can take it. I can take it everywhere. I like it. I mean, sometimes you see people with a thing like this, and then yeah, you have to carry it everywhere. So I like small things, easy to handle, and I the funny thing is that if you are using your own equipment, then you get kind of attached to it. You bring energy in your own equipment. And because of that, there is a connection between the witch or the shaman and his or her equipment. And sometimes it's good not to share things, that somebody picks up my drum. Yeah, some people are okay. I mean, it is just an instrument. It's something different with my staff, for example. But watch out what you are doing if you are picking up tools from somebody else. So, this was the drum.
Yeah, so I cannot show you a drum because I have no feeling for rhythm. So there is another way. By the way, the drum is very useful to get into concentration. Now this looks like a matchbox. And it actually is. But I filled it with rice and I taped the sides so the rice doesn't fly all over. And this sound, that brings you into concentration as well, just as good as a drum does. And about 300 times cheaper. No, but the drum of Dirkje is absolutely beautiful, you know, cowhide and beaver. Yeah, it's really nice. But I use this, works very well, accompanies me to all my journeying to Helheim, or connecting with the runes, or contacting people who are deceased. I use it for everything. And the drum and the rattle, it blocks out the background noises. If you live in an urban area, like I do, Dirkje also lives in a town. So yeah, that's a very helpful tool.
Yeah. Okay. And within Northern Shamanism, a drum is actually not a very common tool. People in the north, with excavations, they did not dig out drums, so they never found drums. But people went into trance state with other things like the rattle and also the bones. I have two deer bones, and if you click them, then you can go into a trance state as well, together with the rattle or together with the drum or just into, you know, it is a little bit silent. you know, and it is, yeah, it is good to use things from animals, and this is absolutely very natural. It's also a good method to go into trance state. It's always good to use noise or rhythm. It helps. So, yeah.
Isn't this what the band Heilung uses in their concerts? The singer, you also see her with two of these bones, you know?
Exactly, yeah. So exactly. Heilung. Yeah, I don't know if you know that band. I think it's German.
Yeah,
and
German
there is also, there are also Dutch guys in that band, I know.
Oh, nice.
But yes, of course, they use that in the band. Yeah.
And by the way, the rattle that I just showed, rattle is not very Northwestern European, by the way. So the bones are, I think that's the most awesome way, but I don't have a pair of bones. So another thing that you can do with your rattle or your drum after you have built up your level of concentration, your trance state, then you can use a staff. And there is a video about the staff, and it shows left or right in this video, the link will show up. And Dirkje also brought her staff.
Yeah, can I show it? Yeah, this is my staff. I like it, also very light. I told you that I like it, that I can carry things with me and not heavy stuff. So this is a very light staff. I prepared it completely myself. I took the things off, the branches, and I put some oil on it. And this is from hazel. This is also in from my neighborhood. And this is a hazel staff. And I also burned some runes in my staff. I don't show it right now, maybe next time. But because that's very personal. Yeah, and it's not completely full of runes and magic signs, just a few for me. I like simple things, and I prefer a few runes, and maybe if I if it feels so, then I can always add some stuff. I also like metal. I do some metal work and silver smithy work, so I want to make a metal top on my staff. It's not ready yet, but I like metal because metal is really a conductor for energy, and I have a connection with metal. I always like metal. I worked in a company that is making things from metal, and yeah, so, and I like smithy work, so yeah, metal is really my thing. Yeah.
And you like heavy metal.
I like heavy metal. Yes. Yeah. That's true.
Yeah. Well, I won't talk too much about my stuff because I made a video about it already. So this one is a very rough one, you know, with the bark still attached. So there's even here a little sharp brands, so I deliberately keep it so rough because I prefer to travel, to journey to the realm of the dead, but also to a dark world called Mirkvider. That's also a destination in the afterlife, but a pretty nasty one. So I'm more into those kind of realms, so I don't want to have a nice polished staff for that. It needs to be a bit rough. It gives the right energy. So, but again, it's all up to you what you do with your stuff. Metal or not, runes or not, remove the bark or not, it's all up to you. There's no good or bad, not at all.
Yeah. And another thing I want to show you is a kind of cap. Witches and European shamans used a blanket or something else to cover the head, because if you're going into trance state, and you can shut yourself out from the outer world, and you can concentrate in your own space, and you can put a blanket all over yourself. And sometimes if you see older old movies or something, people are wearing caps and cloaks and all that kind of things. Yeah, that is from medieval, from ancient times. And I have this one. It's a kind of cap that I'm going to put over me. And then I'm in my own world. And so that's nice because I don't have to wear a whole cloak if it's warm. Yeah, I can use this one. And yeah, I like it. I like it because it helps me concentrating. Yeah.
And it's handmade in
Netherlands. And it is handmade by somebody who make these things.
So that's the pretty option. And this is the low budget option. It's a hoodie. And the hoodie costs maybe €8 or something, I forgot. But it works perfect. Because it's exactly what Dirk just told you. It keeps you in that trance state, you know. It seals you off from the outer world, but at the same time it protects your life energy. Especially if you journey to realms that are not so good with life energy, such as Helheim or Mirkvider or the in-between world, if somebody just deceased. It's always good, and it's always good to be not recognizable, because you can encounter beings that are not so friendly. I mean, this is not New Age, you know, we're not with all kinds of angels of light and fairies and whatnot. You know, you can encounter hostile beings, that's just a fact. I mean, I encountered them before, and that's okay, but protect yourself. It's extremely important to do so. So for the ladies, this cider hood that Dirk showed is just really pretty. But you can wear a scarf around your head just as well.
Yeah. Now, and I think it's the last thing, and this is a heavy iron kettle that I use. It's heavy. It's heavy metal. But this is really heavy iron, and I use this for burning herbs or giving a sacrifice to the gods. And this is a really a witch kettle, yeah, so I like it. And I use the black coals. You can buy in a lot of shop. You can burn them. And you can sacrifice the herbs, whatever herb you want. And you can burn rose leaves or something for love, or other herbs for protection. And it gives a kind of atmosphere, of course. When I am doing rituals with other women, I put this kettle in the middle. It helps also to go into trance state, because you can focus on one thing and you see the smoke, you smell the herbs, it is nice to sacrifice as well. Okay.
And the rooms.
The rooms, yeah. Your rooms.
Yeah, we all use a set.
Okay.
So I store them in this little container. So the rooms are very, very much ancestral. You know, we have made quite a playlist. We will make a total playlist of rooms. And you can use them for magic, for divination. The rooms have their spirit of their own. So you can actually contact the rooms by meditating on them. And this is a great addition for the Northwestern European practitioner. So yeah, you can make them yourself or you can purchase them. That's all up to you. I made these rooms myself. Willow wood. This is my old stuff, actually. So yeah, that's also a thing that is very helpful to have. And it doesn't need to be expensive, because you just saw a brand and pieces and you apply the rooms on them. It's very simple. Yeah.
Okay, that's it for now, I think.
It think so.
Okay.
Okay, so as always, if you like this video, then please like and subscribe. And put something in the comment section if you have questions or you want to share your experiences. And stay safe, stay healthy, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.
Bye bye.